So hi, hello and welcome again, Microbehunter here. Well, this here is a short follow-up video to the video that I published yesterday. Yesterday, if you remember, I put an onion skin here, one of the dry onion skins under the microscope, and I used oil as a mounting medium. And then today I did receive a question that I would like to share with you. And because the question is now, could you also make permanent slides? So how and what would you use as a medium to make a permanent mounted slide with the results you demonstrated using oil? So I've got two mounting media here. This one is PVA glue. It's a water-based mounting medium. And this is Euparal mounting medium, which is actually most commonly used for mounting insects. And what I've done today is I did not take some of the onion skin, but rather, if you know what this is here, this is the so-called the seed coat of a peanut, right? It's very thin and papery, and it's very suitable also for observing under the microscope. And I mounted it already here, here on the left side. That is with the PVA glue, the water-based glue. And here we're using Euparal mounting medium. And yeah, so basically permanent mounts, and the way that they look under the microscope is quite different, right? You can already see over here that this one here on the right side looks a little bit darker. Yeah, it's not because of the side of the seed coat. See, it generally looks darker, and the reason is because it's more transparent. Because this mounting medium, Euparal, is not water-based, contains a solvent, yeah, and a different refractive index, and it interacts differently with the specimen than the water-based mounting medium here, right? So essentially what I would like to do is I would like to simply show it to you under the microscope, because that would then basically address the first question here, yeah, and we can see that we can use the right mounting medium, and then later on, yeah, why not use vegetable oil? What I used yesterday in the onion video, why not use a vegetable oil for all specimens? Yeah, that's an interesting one. There are several reasons for that that I would like to explain to you later. But for right now, let's put this under the microscope, and you're going to see quite a big difference. So this here is the seed coat, the peanut seed coat using Euparal. So that's the one with the solvent under the microscope. You can see that here on the right side, there are darker regions. These are some air bubbles. Yeah. Here we're right at the edge here. I know it doesn't really look like a lot. I mean, we might want to go up with the magnification here, but that's not really my point. Yeah, occasionally you can see maybe some individual cells as well. Look, they're kind of small and tiny. Let me turn on the arrow here. You might just be able to see some tiny cell walls here on the side. But that is, yeah, maybe over here a little bit more. Yeah? But that's actually not the real important thing here. I'd rather would like to now show you how this looks like, how the specimen looks like that's mounted in the PVA glue, the water-based glue. So I'm quickly going to move over. And look, this is how it looks like. Yeah. Black. Yeah, totally way too dark. I did not change the lamp. You can try to focus here a little bit. Yeah. But you see, it's basically almost nothing. You can see almost nothing here, right? I'm going to go up with the brightness now, right? And you see, that's how it looks like. I turn off the arrow again. We don't see any details because it's so dark. Right? You see that essentially the mounting medium that we use has a significant impact on how the specimen appears. So I turned up now the light all the way, and I'm going to now move over again to the one using Euparal, and look how bright it is. It's way overexposed. Yeah? So there is a significant difference in the appearance. We might want to go up a little bit more with the magnification here. Yeah, maybe there are some air bubbles, of course. Yeah. But the idea is the following, that if the mounting medium is compatible with the specimen, like for example it is in this case, then essentially the mounting medium will brighten up and the specimen significantly, to the extent that the light is able to go through, and then we're able to observe the specimens much better. Now again, the reason why I've chosen this specimen is not so because it looks kind of nice or anything interesting here. That's not the point. I really wanted simply to show you the effect of different mounting media on the specimen and why this matters. Yeah, let's go down with the magnification again here. Let's have again, I have to turn down the brightness as well. So that's now the 10 times objective. Yeah, and then again over here, that's the one with the PVA glue, the water-based glue, and it's totally dark. By the way, these two pieces of specimen were right next to each other, so they're not from different parts of the peanut, but actually from the very same, very similar area. Yeah, so basically, this is four times objective. Yeah, so you see, too dark to allow any light to go through. Yeah, and here, yeah, significantly brighter. Yeah, so I would now like to answer the last question that I've got here, and that is what if I use vegetable oil for all specimens instead of water as a mounting medium? Because yesterday I used vegetable oil to observe the onion skin here, right? And I compared it also to water, and the question is now is not if vegetable oil works, why not always use it? And the short answer is because vegetable oil only works well for those specimens that are completely dry. I mean, the skin of the onion here, or even the peanut skin here, they are completely dry, so vegetable oil would work. But as soon as you have any specimen that contains a little bit of water, of course oil doesn't work, because then you have oil and water bubbles forming. It's called an emulsion forming. It's not gonna work well. Yeah, and there is also another reason why vegetable oil is not always suitable besides the water content, and that is simply it's also too difficult to clean, and it also has to do something with the refractive index. Yeah, so basically it means that again the specimen has to have the correct difference in refractive index with the surrounding medium, so that you're able to see something properly. And vegetable oil and water have a different refractive index. And therefore, this also might not work for all specimens. Yeah, so I just wanted to share this with you here, and I'm just going to leave it at that again. Yeah, I wish you all the best, happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around in the next video. Bye bye.